It's so exciting.
Hey, that looks good.
How do you give water to a plant? Happy. This is how I water my plant. It is a geranium.
I water plants like this.
Dorothy, this is how I water my little plant. It needs lots of water.
Thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hi, baby. Baby, how do you water a plant? Oh, thank you, baby. What's that, Dorothy? Okay. Dorothy says that trees don't usually show up like that, out of nowhere. Dorothy says trees usually grow out of the ground. Yeah. Oh, Dorothy, you're so smart. Oh, you're welcome. Elmo wants to know what else grows out of the ground and what doesn't. Don't you? Let's find out. Oh, not again, Troy. Do carrots grow out of the ground?
Yes.
Do oranges grow out of the ground?
No.
But they grow on a tree that does. Do worms grow out of the ground?
No.
But they live in the ground. Except for Slimy. He lives in a trash can. Silly drawer. Elmo loves Slimy. Slimy's Elmo's friend. Elmo has another friend, Cody, who grew his own plant. Cool, huh? Cody told Elmo all about it. First, Cody took some paper towels, crumbled them up nice and tight, and stuffed them in a glass. Then, he took some beans and dropped them on top of the paper towels. See the beans? Now, Cody knows that plants need water to grow, so he poured some water on top of the beans. And he waited. And he watered. And he waited. And he watered. And waited. And watered. And waited. Until finally, after lots of days, the beans began to grow. Wow. Cody put some dirt in a pot. And then, put the bean plant in the pot. Then Cody put some more dirt on top of it so it could stand up nice and straight. Good, Cody. Good, Mommy. Cody knows that plants need sunlight to grow, so he found a nice sunny spot for his bean plant. And he watered it. Cody kept watering the bean plant, and it kept growing. He watered and watered and watered. And the bean plant grew and grew and grew. What a beautiful plant. Great job, Cody. There. Look. Elmo liked Cody's bean plant so much, Elmo's growing one, too. Oh, and while we wait for it to grow, we can find out more about flowers, plants, and trees. But how can we find out more? Hey, yeah. That's right. We can watch the Flower, Plant, and Tree Channel. Go on, TV.
The Flower, Plant, and Tree Channel. All flowers, all plants, all trees. We're growing all the time. And now, the Tree Lady.
Hello, plant lovers. It's me, the Tree Lady. Today on the Flower, Plant, Tree Channel, I'm going to show you how to pretend to be a tree. Don't worry, you can do it. It's as easy as 1, 2, 3. Anyway, all you have to do is use your imagination. Are you ready? Then let's pretend. First, imagine you've got roots that go deep into the ground. Are you imagining? I am. Can't be a tree without roots. That's how you get water and food from the ground. Are you rooted? Good. Now, imagine you've got a nice strong trunk made out of wood. Trees are made out of wood, you know. Ready for more? Good. Pretend that long branches and limbs are growing out from your trunk. Also made of, you guessed it, wood. Beautiful. Now comes the bark. Gotta have bark. Now what? Something's missing. All right, the leaves. Can't leave out the leaves. There, we did it. We're trees. You're really great at pretending. That's it, I think. I guess I can go now. No, I can't. I'm a tree. Boy, I've got some imagination. See you later.
Thank you, Stevie. See? Elmo's pretending to be a tree, too. A giant elmo. But Elmo wants to look at his plant. Whoa. It hasn't stopped growing yet. Elmo will keep waiting. And watering, too. There you go. Boy, and waiting. Elmo would like to find out more about flowers, plants, and trees, wouldn't you? But how? Oh.
Howdy! You want to talk to a cactus?
Yeah, Elmo would love to talk to a cactus.
Yeah.
But wait a minute. Why would Elmo talk to a cactus about flowers, plants, and trees?
Because a cactus is a plant. That's why.
Oh, get out of town.
Huh?
Cactus doesn't look like a plant. Well, where are your leaves at?
Well, I don't have leaves, Elmo. But I have these prickly spiny things called spines, and I'm still a plant. I can even grow a flower. Watch.
Pretty! Boy, then Elmo will water cactus.
No, thanks, but not now, Elmo.
Huh? But Elmo thought plants need water.
Well, plants do need water. Mm-hmm. But I don't need as much as other plants. That's why I live in the desert, where it's hot and dry and sunny. Yeah, I love it. And right now, Elmo, I couldn't drink another drop.
Do other plants live in the hot, dry, sunny desert with cactus?
Well,
sure, I do.
Wow, that's tumbleweed.
It sure is. What a tumbler.
Lots of plants live in the desert.
Really?
Uh-huh. Bye.
Bye, Tumbleweed.
Yep, there are lots of plants that live in other places.
What other places?
Well, almost some plants live in the big cities.
Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo watering plants in a big city.
Plants live in the ocean, where there's already plenty of water.
Okay.
Lots of plants live in the jungle. You see, plants can live just about anywhere.
Elmo sees. Ooh, look. Elmo's bean plant can live right here on Elmo's world. If it ever starts growing...
It'll grow, Elmo. Just be patient.
Okay.
Well, gotta go catch some rays. Adios.
Cactus, bye. That was a friendly cactus. Oh, Elmo knows another friendly plant, Stinky. Mm-hmm. So Elmo made a video of Stinky the Plant with Dad's camera. It's called Stinky the Plant by Elmo. Oh, TV! TV, where are you? TV! TV, stop growing! You're not a plant! Okay, be a TV. Now turn yourself on. Good TV.
What do you want me to do, Elmo? Do I look all right?
You look all right.
How are my leaves?
They're very pretty.
How's my stem?
Nice.
How's my nose?
Okay.
Nobody's ever made a video of me before. Shouldn't I be doing something?
Stinky's doing just fine being a plant.
Oh, thank you, Elmo. And you're doing just wonderfully being a monster.
Thank you, Stinky.
You're welcome.
Okay, now let's play for the camera.
Okay. Bloopy, 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 bloopy.
Thank you, TV. Now Elmo wants to look at his plan again. Look, 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 look. Oh, look, it's starting to grow. See, it has tiny roots and a stem. Yay! Elmo loves his new plant. Oh, Elmo loves all kinds of flowers, plants, and trees. So does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the Flowers, Plants, and Trees song.
Ooh, the Flowers, Plants, and Trees song. My favorite. Mind if I sing along?
Oh, no, no. Sing with Elmo. You sing, too. Here we go. Bananas too, and Dorothy has a question. What do you do with a banana? Good question, Dorothy. Oh, maybe Mr. Noodle knows. I'm just gonna check with Mr. Noodle, Dorothy. Shade! Shade, you're covering Elmo. Shade. Oh, hey, Mr. Noodle. How do you use a banana? Yeah, you.
Mr. Noodle, what do you do with a banana?
Let's see.
No uses a phone.
No, you don't talk into it. A banana's not a telephone.
Yeah.
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
No. Don't blow into a banana.
That's not what you do with a banana.
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
long.
You peel it.
And you eat it.
It's not something you dip in ink and then write.
That's it, Mr. Noodle. Yeah, good, Mr. Noodle.
Let the banana go, Mr. Noodle.
Oh, Dorothy thinks maybe we should ask someone else. What do you do with the banana?
You eat it!
Dorothy wants to know how.
Dorothy, this is how I eat a banana. I really love bananas. Dorothy, this is how you eat a banana. Dorothy, this is how you eat a banana. First, you go like this and take the other side and pull it down. And you take the other side and pull it down again. And you take the other side and pull it down and you eat it.
Thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. What do you do with a banana? There you go. Yeah! Thank you, baby! And now, Elmo has a question for you. How many bananas are on this hat? Let's count them and see. That's one. Of course. banana smoothies made with milk and what else? Bananas! Then, for dessert, they made banana pudding topped with slices of bananas, banana bread, fried plantains, banana pancakes, banana smoothies, and banana pudding. And they all look so yummy, they invited Michael's friends over for a banana feast. Yay! Thanks to apples. No, I was just kidding. Bananas! And that's how Elmo's friend Michael had a banana meal. Now Elmo wants to find out even more about bananas. How can Elmo find out more? Yeah, that's right. Elmo can watch the Banana Channel. Good idea, TV.
The Banana Channel. Programming with appeal.
And now, the story of bananas.
Bananas are fruits that come in bunches.
Enjoy a banana, it's a very funny fruit.
People eat them at breakfast, then they munch them at their lunches.
Boy, a banana is a very fine fruit.
There's no meal of banana who won't fit into.
Chew on a banana, it's a very fine fruit.
It's the very best fruit that I ever bit into. And people eat them raw.
It's a treat, a banana. It's a very fine fruit.
All around the world, it's the fruit that people gnaw.
And if you eat a banana, it's a very fine fruit.
You can slice it on your cereal, so nutritious. Or bake it in banana bread, mmm, delicious. To put one in your lunchbox or the pocket of your suit.
Coming up next, a bunch of other stuff.
But Elmo wants to learn even more about bananas, don't you? How can we learn more?
Here comes a banana, I'm
that?
The top banana. Here comes a banana, I'm the top banana.
Talk to me, kid. Thank you.
Are you a banana?
Am I a banana? Kid, I'm the top banana. Thank you.
Because Elmo wants to know more about bananas.
Kid, you know more about bananas than you think. Thank you.
Really?
Absolutely. Like, what do you call this yellow part on my outside? Thank you.
That's the peel. The peel.
Right. Thank you. And what do you call this part on the inside? Thank you.
Well, that's the fruit. Yeah, the part that you eat.
That's right. And it's good for you. And we're healthy. And that's it. Thank you. Kid, you know enough about bananas to be a banana. Thank you.
Oh, look. Look, Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a banana in a banana tree. Thank you.
Yeah, kid. Bananas grow on trees in hot places. Thank you.
Ba ba banana, ba ba banana. Oh no, no, monkey! Elmo's not a banana. Elmo's Elmo.
You can also find bananas in a supermarket in the fruit section. Thank you.
Ted, you're it!
What? Oh, Banana Ted! Yay! Monkey, where are you? Elmo's gonna find you! Oh, there you are! Come back here, Monkey!
Did you ever see a banana split? Thank you!
Uh-huh.
Well, you're about to see one split again! Thank you! Stay away, my kid!
Elmo, one more question about bananas. Can a banana peel itself? What do you think? Well, Elmo made a video with Dad's Panda. Yeah, it's called Can a Banana Peel Itself? By Elmo. TV! Oh, there you are. Go ahead. No, bananas can't peel themselves. Oh, thanks, TV. Bye-bye. Thank you. Boy, Elmo really loves bananas. Oh, so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the banana song. Yay! Here we go.
Hairbrush.
Mr. Noodle?
Yeah, that's it. That's a hairbrush, Mr. Noodle. Now, show us how you brush your hair.
That's long hair.
Really long.
But Mr. Noodle, it's going to take a long time to brush your hair that way.
That's one way to brush your hair, Mr. Noodle. One good way.
Oh, good idea, Dorothy. Dorothy thinks we should ask someone else. How do you brush your hair? Good question, Dorothy.
This is how I brush my hair, Dorothy.
Dorothy, I don't use a brush, I use a comb.
Dorothy, I use a pick.
Thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hi, baby. Oh, baby, how do you... Baby, how do you brush your hair? Wait a minute. You don't have a lot of hair to brush. That's cool. Thank you, baby. Oh, Elmo has lots of hair all over Elmo's body. It's called fur, and it needs lots of brushing. Hey, Elmo has a question for you. How many hairbrushes does it take to brush Elmo's fur? Let's count them and see.
One.
One hairbrush.
Two.
Two hairbrushes. Three hairbrushes.
Four.
Four hairbrushes.
Five. Six.
Six tickling hairbrushes. And one ticklish Elmo. Great counting, everybody. Elmo has lots of hair to brush, but not everything has hair. Elmo wants to know what has hair and what doesn't. Let's find out. Drawer? Where are you, Drawer? Drawer, where are... There you are. Come down here now, Drawer. Come on. You're such a silly Drawer. Do birthday cakes have hair?
No.
Do mailboxes have hair?
No.
Too bad. Elmo thought it looked nice.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Do horses have hair?
Yes.
But not that kind of hair. Horse hair. Do tortoises have hair?
No.
What? You never heard of the tortoise and the hare?
Uh-uh.
That's a joke. Yeah, I don't get it either. I'm going home.
Where did everybody go? Oh, thank you, TV. There you are. Boy, this is a lot of hair to take care of. Elmo needs a haircut. Elmo's friend, Joseph, just got his very first haircut and taught Elmo all about it. Joseph's mom took him to get his very first haircut because his hair was getting too long. Joseph had never been to a barbershop before and didn't know what to expect. Mario the barber was very nice. He put Joseph in a special chair, and then he put a cape around him. The barber's chair was really neat. It went up. Going up. And down. And around, and around, and around. Joseph really liked the chair. Then it was time for the haircut. Joseph was a little scared. He never had a haircut before. There was a bigger boy in the chair next to him having his hair cut, and he wasn't scared. So Joseph decided to let Mario go ahead and cut his hair. Mario cut, and he cut, and he cut, until he was all through. Joseph's mommy really liked the haircut. And so did Joseph. Mario cut it just the way they wanted it. Cool haircut, Joseph. Elmo likes it too. Oh, look, Mr. Noodle is still brushing his hair. Oh, looking good, Mr. Noodle. Keep brushing. But Elmo still wants to find out more. More about hair. But how can Elmo find out more? Oh, yeah, good idea, TV. We can watch the Hair Channel. Turn on. Thank you.
You're watching the Hair Channel. All hair, all the time. And now, here's our story.
The kingdom where everybody's hair looked the same. Once upon a time, there was a kingdom where everybody's hair looked the same.
I, your king, hereby decree that everyone should wear their hair just like mine.
And everyone did. The royal chef wore her hair just like the king's. The royal jester wore his hair just like the king. Even the royal hamster wore his hair just like the king. Everyone in the entire kingdom wore their hair just like the king's. Everyone, that is, except for little Liddy LaRue.
Little girl, why doesn't your hair look the same as mine?
I'm sorry, Your Majesty, but no matter what I do, my hair won't go that way. It's just different. Besides, I like it this way. I really like it.
But this is the kingdom where everybody's hair looks the same. You can't have hair that looks different.
But, Your Majesty, what's wrong with everybody having different hairstyles?
What's wrong with it? I'll tell you what's wrong with it. Nothing.
So the king made a new decree.
I, your king, hereby decree that from now on, everybody can wear their hair any way they want.
And everybody did. They wore their hair in all different kinds of styles and colors, and they all looked good. Even the king got a new style. And that looked good, too.
Hey, bald is beautiful.
And soon there were so many different beautiful hairstyles that they had to rename the kingdom where everyone has different hairstyles. The end!
Coming up next, From Hair to Eternity, followed by When Harry Met Sally.
Thank you, TV. Oh, and very nice hair. Oh, Elmo loves all different kinds of hair. Straight, curly, short, long. What's the longest hair in the world? Excuse Elmo.
You want to see the world's longest hair?
Yeah.
You got it! Sorry.
Wow. This hair is really long. Who are you?
Oh, well, I'm Rapunzel. You know, from the story of Rapunzel?
Huh?
I'm the one who was locked in the tall tower and people had to climb up my hair to get in. You know, like that.
Oh, yeah! Elmo loves that story, and so does Dorothy. Oh, look, look! Dorothy's imagining Elmo in the story of Rapunzel.
Oh, boy, oh, boy.
It's really lonely in this tower. Somebody get Rapunzel out of here! Help! Somebody help!
Do not worry, fair Rapunzel. I, the very handsome prince, will save you. Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair.
Okay.
Here I come to save the fair Rapunzel.
Okay.
Oh, it's over here. Here I come. Back. Hey.
Oh, thank goodness you're here. Now Rapunzel can get out of this tower.
Yeah, but how?
Like this. Yes! Come on, go down.
What's the crow?
Okay. Oh,
oh. Oh,
okay. Gotcha. Yeah! Looking good!
You like this?
Looking good!
I don't know if it's my style.
See ya!
Oh, bye! Is this conditioned at all?
Oh, Rapunzel's free! Yay!
Yeah! Woohoo!
Thank you, Prince! Thank you very much! Bye-bye!
Yes, you're welcome! Goodbye! Wait a minute. Now I'm stuck in this tower! Rapunzel, come back! Bring a ladder! Yoo-hoo, Rapunzel! And a hairbrush! And moose! Yoo-hoo!
Oh! Oh. Well, that's not exactly how the story goes, but, I liked it.
Oh, good!
That fish of yours has some imagination.
She sure does!
Yes, well, anyway, I've got to go. I have an appointment at the beauty parlor.
Ah.
I'm thinking of wearing my hair up. Way up. See you, Elmo.
Oh, bye, Rapunzel. Bye.
Oh, 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 dear. Oh, sorry.
Oh, oh boy.
Oh, that's the third time this week.
Thank
you. All right, Elmo?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry about my hair. Tell you what, I'll leave that way.
Okay.
Okay, bye, Elmo. Okay. Bye.
Bye, Rapunzel.
Wow. Boy, Rapunzel sure has really long hair. Elmo has a friend who has really short hair. Bert. Elmo loves Bert's hair. That's why Elmo made a video about Bert's hair with Claire's camera. It's called Bert's Hair by Elmo. TV! TV, where are you? Oh, there you are, TV. Are you so fine?
Elmo, what's going on? I was taking a bath, and now what? What do you want me to do?
Oh, just hold still, Bert.
What? 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 What?
Just hold still.
Okay.
Okay? All right. Here we go. There. See, this is Bert's hair.
Yeah,
see how it sticks up all by itself?
Well, I just took a bath. Of course, I washed it.
Oh, well, Elmo loves Bert's hair. Oh, can Elmo touch Bert's hair?
Oh, no, I still have to put that gunk on it first.
Oh, please, Bert, please.
All right, Elmo.
Okay. So,
did you enjoy yourself?
Oh, thanks, Bert.
Are you finished now?
No. And that's Bert's hair by Elmo. Now Elmo's finished, but now we get to play. Come on, Bert.
No, I gotta put some gunk in my hair and comb it now.
Oh,
Elmo.
Come on, Bert. Bert. Oh, thank you, TV. Elmo loves hair. So does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the hair song. You okay, TV? What's wrong? Oh, you want to dance and sing too? Okay. Here we go. Sing along too.
Hair.
Visit Sesame Street on the web at www.sesame.com.